Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's a good privilege for us, for me to stand here before you and deliver the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
You know, we don't take it for granted when they ask you to stand and preach. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we are so grateful to Pastor Amos who allow us to stand here and to all the leadership. Amen.
Amen.
So today I've got a few words that we're going to share. I hope you get blessed. Amen.
Amen.
And the moderator somehow, some way is introducing my message. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So today the Lord has put in my heart to talk about the benefit of the obedience to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The benefit of the obedience to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we're going to read from Genesis 12. Madam Muzo, can you help us there? Genesis 12, from verse 1 to 4.
Now the Lord had said to Abraham, get out of your country, from your family, and from your father's house, to a land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation. Mm-hmm. I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you. I will curse he who curses you. And in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed. So Abram departed as the Lord had spoken to him, and Lot went with him. And Abraham was 75 years old when he departed from Haran.
Amen. I'll just start by defining the word obedience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Obedience means to comply with an order, to comply with a request, to comply with law. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As they've asked me to preach, I come and preach. I obey. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As we have come today to worship God, you have complied to the rule of God.
Amen.
You say, come and worship me.
Amen.
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 Obedience means also to put yourself under someone's authority. Amen?
Amen.
Obedience is very important in our lives. Amen.
Amen.
You know, somehow you have exercised authority on somebody. It might be at work, you are in a leading position, or in your family, at class, at school, you exercise authority. And people under your authority, when they do what they have asked for, you feel good, isn't it? You feel obey. Same with our God. When he asks us to do something, when we obey his word, he feels good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, it's like a child. Before I say that, you know, obedience goes together with trust. You can't trust somebody. You can't obey somebody if you don't trust him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's like a child. You put a child on the table and you ask that child to jump and you catch him. The child will jump because he trusts you. Because he knows that you will catch him. Hallelujah. You won't see any risks involved. You just jump and then you catch him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Here we are talking about Abraham. Abraham, God visited him and said, Abraham, get out of your country. Get out of your family. Get out of your father's house and go to a land I will show you. Hallelujah. Abraham didn't refuse. Abraham didn't argue with God. Like some of us here, they ask you to go somewhere. We ask questions after questions. Hallelujah. Amen. Abraham was 75 years old. That's an age of retirement. Hallelujah. Age where you have already invested. You start eating from your investment. That's where God says, stand up and go. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I wonder if it was you. You could have asked questions. Hallelujah. Where am I going? Abraham didn't ask where he's going. Hallelujah. Is there any hospital where I'm going? Is there McDonald's where I'm going? Is there power? Is there water? But Abraham didn't ask any question. Just stood up and go. Amen.
Amen.
You know, when God wants to bless somebody, he will take you out of your family. He will take you out of your house. Hallelujah. He will take you out of your country. What do I mean? I mean, when God wants to bless you, you should get out from your comfort zone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You should get out of your comfort zone. God wants to put you aside for a purpose. Amen.
Amen.
God, once he wants to bless you, he will separate you from a lot of things. Get out of your country means get out of your sins. Amen?
Amen?
To get out of your country means to separate you from what you find comfortable. Where God doesn't see you there. God cannot bless you where you are. God asks you, move first from that place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When God wants to bless you, he will ask you to separate yourself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Separation, it's a process. And sometimes it's a painful process.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But you have to go through that process for you to get blessed. Amen.
Amen.
Separation from your sin. Separation from your idols. There's so many people have got idols. So many people got few things that are not worthy to be around. But God wants you to get out from that place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Separation from all those rubbish things that are surrounding you. God wants you to get out of those things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Get out of your comfort zone, then you get your blessing. Hallelujah. Christians today, they know a lot. They are no longer have a teachable spirit. They argue for everything and anything. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They know everything. You speak to them, no, they don't obey. God is saying, get out of your comfort zone. Get out of those rubbish things that are surrounding you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Separation is very important. It's a process, painful process. Hallelujah. You know, it was not easy, even for Abraham, to separate from his family. Hallelujah. It was not easy for him to separate with the family. That's why it took Lot. Hallelujah. For him to have some, for him to get somebody with him where he's going, a family member. Hallelujah. But down the track, God did what he did. Amen.
Amen.
Separation. For you to be blessed, you need to get out from something. Amen.
Amen.
Get out of something, then God will bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, sometimes you find yourself in places where you shouldn't be. Amen?
Amen.
There's no gain there where you are, but you're still there. Hallelujah. There's some places, some churches where you are, you don't go, you don't learn anything, but you're still there. There's some relationship in which we are, you don't gain anything, but you're still there. Amen? Some friendship that is useless, but you're still there. God is saying that, separate you from that. Get out of that place for you to get blessed. Hallelujah. As long as you are still there, you are delaying your process. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As long as you are still there, you are not obeying, your process will take long. It will be difficult for you to get blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The promises of God will take time to fulfill. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Be obedient. You know, obedience is like a seed that we put in someone's life. Amen? Obedience is like a seed you sow. And the best time to sow is when in a tender age, when the child is still a baby. Hallelujah?
Amen.
That's why the Bible says in Proverbs 22:6, train up the child the way he should go.
Amen.
When you grow up, you won't depart from it. If you teach your child obedience, when you grow up, you won't depart from it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are we together?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the best time to sow obedience in your child. Let's go back to this chapter 12, verse 2. We will see the benefit of Abraham obeying God. Hallelujah. Verse 2. After obeying, after getting out of your country, after getting out of your family, your father's house, what God said to Abraham, I will make you a great nation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God will make Abraham a great nation after he left his family. Amen. It's up to you. It's like you today. God wants to make you a great nation. But first, get out of what you are, in which things we are. Hallelujah. God will bless you if you obey, if you live. Hallelujah. God will bless you if you leave your sins. God will bless you if you depart from your idols. From every rubbish that you are doing, God will bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he will make your name great. Hallelujah. Who doesn't want his name to be great? Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want my name to be great. You want your name to be great. Hallelujah. But obey first what God's saying. Amen. And you shall be a blessing. Hallelujah. Yeah. That makes me crazy here. To be a blessing. Can you imagine? There is somebody somewhere is waiting for you to obey, for him to get blessed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You will be a channel of blessing for somebody.
Amen.
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 To be a channel of a blessing, that's a huge responsibility. Somewhere, somehow, someone is sick, waiting for you to be obedient to God so that God can pour out anointing of healing for you to go and bless that person.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somewhere churches are being to be, are waiting to be built because you be the channel of that blessing. Amen?
Amen.
And still we are not obeying. What a shame. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Someone is waiting. Someone is waiting for you to obey. Hallelujah. And God will bless those who bless you. Amen? And you take care of those who are cursing you. You take care of them, himself. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you must be able to obey to God. Amen? We should be able to obey to God. And not only obeying God, but obeying also the servant of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To be obedient to the servant of God. Don't take them for granted. Hallelujah. I'm talking about the true servant of God. Because there is servant and servant. Amen? Obey the servant of God. And there is a blessing. Can you read, please, in... Let's read in 2 Kings. 2 Kings, chapter 4. Madame Zo, are you there? 2 Kings, 4. Here we see this widow was not talking to God. Hallelujah. She was talking to a servant of God, Elisha. Hallelujah. You know the story. The creditors came to take the son as slaves. Hallelujah. Since she didn't have money to pay back. And Elisha asked her, "What do you have?" She said, "A jar of wine." And Elisha said, "Go out and collect some vessels and start pouring in those vessels." Amen? And she did as she was told. And she got blessed. Hallelujah?
Amen.
Obeying the servant of God, it's important. You know, sometimes you can take the servant for granted. Hallelujah? You are used to him. Hallelujah. When he says, you don't do what he says. Sometimes he can speak his mind. Sometimes he can speak a mind of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But once he says something, since he's a servant, God will back him. Amen?
Amen?
God will back him, and that word will be fulfilled. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even your parents, don't take them for granted. You are used to them, yes. But sometimes they can speak as servant of God. And when they speak, obey. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because God knows them. God will back the word and you will be blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. You know, Jesus himself taught us the obedience because he was obedient to the will of the Father until death. Amen. Hallelujah. Last Sunday, Pastor Amos touched about obedience. And I was blessed with that statement. Listen to this. If you are obedient to the leading of the Holy Spirit, you will be connected to the very right purpose of your life. That's powerful. Hallelujah. I was excited when I heard that. I was preparing already my message. Then I say I will include in my message. Hallelujah. Amen. If you are obedient to the leading of the Holy Spirit, you will be connected to the very right purpose of your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's a powerful statement, Pastor.
Amen.
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 Obedience will usher you to your destiny.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, if you are obedient, your destiny is just there for you, waiting for you. Hallelujah. Obedience will bring blessing not only to you, but to the entire generation.
Hallelujah.
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 So don't muck around with these things. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's not for just for vain that you are maybe the only one who has been saved in your family. Mm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The entire generation can be saved because of you, because of your obedience. The entire family can be saved because of your obedience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The entire neighborhood can be saved because of your obedience. You know, in some neighborhoods, there's witches, wizards who are marching around, going around and making people feel bad. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But because you are there, they are fear. They come, they see fire there, then they just go away. And your neighborhood is quiet just because of your obedience.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, my God. Obedience will trigger miracles in your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Obedience will trigger miracles in your life.
Amen.
Can you read quickly, brother?
John 21 from 5.
Then Jesus said to them, "Children, have you any food?" They answered him, "No." And he said to them, "Cast the net on the right side of the boat,
yes,
and you will find some."
Hallelujah.
So they cast, and now they were not able to throw it in because of the multitude
of fish. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Obedience will trigger miracle in your life. Where was this fish? Can we ask that question? Where was this fish where Simon Peter was fishing the whole night? He didn't even get a single one. But in the morning when they saw Jesus, Jesus asked them a question. Did you get something? He said, "No. But throw your net again on the right side." And he obeyed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As long as you obey, you trigger miracle in your life. Amen?
Amen?
Because as long as Peter starting to throw the net, the fish gathered. They were, I don't know where they were, but they gathered in one place and then miracle take place. Amen?
Amen.
Same with that the widow. Amen? She had only one jar of oil. But she obeyed the word. And she started pouring. And the word was just coming out. Coming out, until there were no more vessels. Obedience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Obedience will testify the goodness of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Obedience will testify the goodness of God. I've got a verse for that too. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can we go? Second King, brother. Second King 5:15.
And he returned to the man of God, he and all his aides, and came and stood before him, and he said, "Indeed, now I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Now therefore, please take a gift from your servant." But he said, "As the Lord lives, before whom I stand, I will receive nothing."
Hallelujah.
He asked him to take it.
Yes. Thank you, brother.
Amen.
This is Naaman. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Full of leprosy in his body. Amen?
Amen.
The servant of God said, "Go and dip yourself in the water, in the river Jordan." He refused, but he accepted. And the result was there. And then he said, in verse 15, he said, where's that verse again? Hallelujah. Yes, that's the verse I'm looking for. Can you repeat it, brother? Hallelujah.
Indeed, now I know that there's no God in all the earth except in Israel.
Amen? Amen. Did you hear that? Because of what? The obedience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So obedience pays. Amen? Obedience pays. It's not for granted that we are asking you guys to obey. To obey the Holy Spirit. To obey the word of God. To obey the word of your pastor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I can't finish by talking about the opposite of obedience. Disobedience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
disobedience, I think it's the fruit of the evil spirit. Because the devil can see what you've got in store, what God has planned for you. And for you to start, for him to start blocking you, to start pushing you away from your destiny, start putting disobedience in you. Hallelujah. Start putting disobedience in you, in a child, in adult, for you to step away from your blessing. Hallelujah. So people should be careful. It's costly. Disobedience to God. It's costly. You know the story of Jonah. Jonah was sent by God to go and preach to Nineveh. Hallelujah. But he took another way. He went on the ship. But God struck that ship. Amen? He shook the ship. And you know what happened? All those marines on the ship, they start throwing all the goods in the water. They start throwing in the water. Throwing what they lost. There were businessmen there. And they lose because of what? Disobedience of somebody. It's up to somebody here. Maybe what's going through in your life, it's because you disobey. What is going into your life, in your family life? People are sick from father, mother, and the child from the old generation because of your disobedience. Hallelujah. People don't have jobs. People don't have money because of your disobedience. Just obey God and things will change. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Obey God and things will change. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can we stand up, please? Just take a moment to think about the word of God. To think of what God has told you. Did you obey? Amen. Did you obey or disobey? I just want to say yes to Lord this morning. Just say yes to God this morning. Don't reject, don't resist the word of God this morning. Say yes to Jesus.